Right, hello. I've finished preparing everything I need for the pulverizer. So let's get on and do that. So, machine frames. So we shall do this one. Have I got enough everything in here? I'm going to make two machine frames. So we need 8 iron ingots. I think I've got those. What I haven't got is I've only got 2 glass. Let's get the others. Should be some more in here. Plenty of that. Oops, I don't want the birch sapling. And that must have fallen into the hopper when I was cutting down the birch tree. So let's put the glass up here. Put the glass away. 2 machine frames. And we should have a redstone reception core, which is 1 gold with 2 redstone around. So I've done those already. So we should be able to simply make this. Not quite. What have I not got on me here? Redstone reception coil. In copper ingots, I think, is the problem. Yes, I need 4 copper ingots. Oh. That will be enough aubries for 4 copper ingots. I was forgetting to make the copper ingots. Thought I'd got plenty of those. Right, 2 are good to start with, so now I should be able to just click this recipe. Yes, great. 1 pulverizer. And let's go back to the quest book now. Quick look, that one's done. Easing the pain. This time we've got to make the sawmill. Okay, and the sawmill is I think is almost exactly the same. Very similar, so let's just shift click that one. Now I needed an axe, a pristine axe, which I've got prepared. Machine frame, redstone reception coil, 2 planks, and 2 copper ingots, which should now be in here. And I've got the sawmill. So let's go back to the quest book. So now I can claim the reward. Let's just pick the right one. Okay, now I've got the heart canister. Let's put the heart canister up. So now I've got 18 health and the reward bag. It's a greater reward bag, which I think is actually useless. Well, we'll see. Yes, fairly useless. So now I've got 4 wooden instruments, which I shall simply put in straight away into the trash can. Now let's just do something with what we've got. I'm not sure I'm going to build all of this stuff yet, but for the time being I'm going to put it down over here. Because we haven't got much. We've got 2 machines. So let's put those down like that. So they're facing pulverizer and up. And then we need to power those. So what we're going to do is we're going to take them. What I do need for this is 1 lever. And the reason you need a lever, or cobblestone could, is it needs a redstone signal for the motor to be turned on. So let's do that. I could use a redstone torch, of course, which is another solution. Let's do it like that. 1 redstone torch. Lever might be better because you can turn it off, but I don't think you ever want to turn it off. So where is everything that I need for this? There's the dynamo and the energy conduit is... Where did I put that away? Well, it's not in there. I thought it was in there, actually. And it's not in there either. Got it on me? Definitely not got it on me, have I? No. Let's have a quick look in here again. to sort that chest. Sometimes easier to see when you've sorted things. There's nothing there. That's very strange. I must have put it somewhere. I'll sort that as well. I wouldn't have put it in here because this is where I keep the food and the wooden stuff. Or maybe I put it in here. Oh, yes, I did. Good. And a battery. So what we'll do, we'll put the leadstone energy cell down. Conduit, let's put the conduit here. One here and one here. And let's put the battery in the middle of those two, or the energy cell, I mean. And let's put on top of the energy, let's put the motor, let's put the dynamo here. That's now facing that. But this needs a redstone signal, which means I need a stone slab. Have I got a stone slab with me? No. Let's go and get a stone slab. I've got plenty of those in. What's in this chest, actually? I was expecting to see them there. Here. Stone brick slabs. What we will do very quickly is to put one of these stone brick slabs underneath the motor. That and put the redstone torch on it here, like this. Now that should, actually I hadn't got it in the right place. That was clever. Try that again. Let's take this redstone torch and put it there. Now all it needs is some blood. Let's check the connections on this thing. And it's facing the other direction. So let's take my crescent hammer and right click it. I should be able to get it to the front, which I have. Click in the middle. Let's go to there. So we need outputs on the two sides and inputs on the other faces. Is that right? Yes, there you see it's orange, which means it's an output, and all the rest of these are inputs. So all we now need is another portable tank. And I don't have enough copper, do I? So let's just... I wonder if I can do this very quickly. Let's just pinch this portable tank on here. Because it would be worthwhile demonstrating this for the time being. And let's put this portable tank directly on the dynamo. We have to make an output portable tank and we need one bucket of blood. Let's go and get one bucket of blood. Alright. And we should put that one bucket of blood on into this chest, into this tank. And we should see the energy cell getting some energy in. No. Maybe I need to change this to being an actual... See, it's definitely disappeared. The blood has gone into this, but hasn't produced any power. 8 TRF, which is not enough. Let's have a look. Zero. Still zero. Oh, moment. Ah, oh, look. 48,000 RF. And not quite. 24,000. Nearly 24,000. So that's what happened. Let's go and get some more blood. Let's get. I can't do 5 buckets actually, because I've got too much stuff. But what we can do is we can put this copper aubries into the pulverizer. Just a second. Now, those turned into 16 pulverized copper, which is, then they have to be cooked. So, of course, we can then take those. That's doubled it. You see, we had 4 and I've got 16 from it. We can put those into here. In fact, what's worth now doing is to make a redstone furnace, because with a redstone furnace we can use the power from the blood to cook these up. And in fact, we can also use that redstone furnace to cook up zombie meat flesh, because that will actually turn it into leather. So we've got two copper ingots. I need more, don't I? I need 8. So I won't wait for those, because I wanted to do the portable tank. What else have we got on here that I don't need? I've got this birch sapling. I don't want that. Let's put that away. Anything else I don't want in here? I don't really want the redstone torch. So it was working with the redstone torch. And that's where my other 10 buckets went to. Oh, look, spider. In fact, let's get rid of some, make some more blood. I can't, as I tried to do these before, I can't get the spiders. What I'm going to do though is to make a mob grinder. And with the mob grinder, I will be able to do it easier. See, he's actually not there. You can just see him, just in there, but you can't reach him though with the, at least with this one. So, where were we now? We're going to put, this has got zero energy in there. I'm going to put some buckets into here, which should then give me some energy in here. Yes, you see it's going up nicely now. And let's just move everything around a bit so I can get the energy, blood. So now it's going right up. Well, you can't actually, you don't have any GUI on the motor here, so you really don't know what levels of, there's nothing, you can't click, right click it or anything like that, so you don't know what level it is at. But you can see the energy cell here, we've already got 70,000 RF. And that's enough for these two machines, certainly. And that's full, and the sawmill's full. And what I said, it's a sawmill. It's very efficient at chopping wood. Let's go and have a look at this. I'll take my little axe here and just chop some wood down. And I'm going to call this a day after I've done this. Oh, that's unfortunate. It's a larger tree than normal. Oops. Try jumping. Right, I should be able to reach that last one. Hopefully this is the last one. Nope, it's not the last one. Actually, it's not a big tree, it's just a tall tree. Right. That's probably break in a second. I should wait for a spruce sapling. We'll probably put one more than one from there, so let's just take one out of here. And plant that one down here. Right, now, the sawmill. This is the pulverizer, and this is the sawmill. I should swap those over because I'm going to do that all the time. Put in those, we shall now get 6 spruce planks from one without using any, or very little blood anyway. I'm not sure exactly how much this uses on the recipe, so look. Spruce, so it's about 800 RF. And RF is about one bucket, was around, it's about 5, wasn't it? No, it was 5 cuts was one bucket. And I think one bucket produced about 60,000, so it's fairly efficient at doing this. That's a nice little GUI problem there. Right, until next time, I'm I'm going to call this a day. I'm going to collect my saplings if any's dropped down. One has anyway. Oh, that's strange. I expect to see more than one. In fact, they'll get me crook out and just finish this tree off. Maybe I'll get one or two more for that. Nope. Until next time, bye for now. Hello everybody, I'm back again. And welcome to another part of my episode 12. And I've been very busy. First of all, I extended this altar and added a whole load of runes of sacrifice. The altar itself is quite straightforward. It's one block. I didn't explain when I built the tier 3, but it's actually one block down, as you can see, and one block out. So you have one block at the middle here, then you have three, and now we've got five runes. And the corners here are two blocks high with a redstone. I just jumped down there. I saw her. Let me just do this. Oops, I almost thought I saw a slime. Yes, I did. Look. In fact, I've got my jetpack on at the moment. And I haven't actually got very much enough blood in my altar at the moment. But because I've got these runes of sacrifice, that will increase the amount of blood that goes in here quite a lot. And you'll see that life essence is going down, because that's filling up these tanks here. And hopefully LP isn't, but I'll just check that. You've got to make sure you don't have 1005. Yeah, it's a constant. Oops. Right, so what I did here is I filled the rest of this with wedges, and quite a large number of these I've converted already to being runes of sacrifice, so we get more blood. And that's actually what I'm working on at the moment, to extend that and make sure it's full with runes of sacrifice. So I need another, it looks like another nine. Yes, I need nine more. So I have to be patient and wait for the mobs to spawn. But also what I've done, I'll show you to understand, but a bit crazy at the moment. Oops, falling in my water yet again. I'll show you down on the underground side of things. What I did is I dragged some fluid conduit, fluid duct here, from the altar going out here, and it goes all the way down into this tank here, and then it stops there. And I also have got some another fluid duct coming up from here. And what I'm planning to do here is to put a harvester, and at the bottom put a sludge boiler. And here I'm using the blood as a sort of an energy conduit, so I'll have a dynamo here to power these machines. I've got plenty of, and you can still actually walk underneath this, and it's the same here. I shall take you up. I've turned off my jetpack, haven't I? I've got this dynamo, got the blood coming into here from the altar, which of course means that the altar's now not big enough, so I'm going to have to make the altar bigger. Well, the altar itself's bigger, but the mob's spawning, but I shall extend out another probably two blocks all round and put some conveyor belts in. That's my goal. And before I go to the nether, I shall do that. What else I've done? I've extended the area underneath the base a large amount. As you can see here, we've got I've started to make a bit of a garden, planted some trees. And I want to have two harvesters. I want to have one harvester for the Aubrey bushes and one harvester for the garden or the farm. And here you will notice, yes, I'm not running out of LP this time. Let's actually fly up. I don't want to waste the jetpack, because I haven't got any way to power it up. What I didn't shoot here is I've got there were two quests. The first quest was, let's go back, was this one here, Rituality, where I had to make the inscription tools. But also at the same time I had to go, and wouldn't it be grand, go and visit a new place. And when I've done all of this I shall get some scented artificial hives, another quarter of a heart and a choice of reward bags. So we'll have a quick look at where I've gone to. And eat at the same time, of course. It's actually, it was rather a long time. And the reason I didn't film this, putting this path down just takes forever. Making the blocks. And it was around about, fortunately I visited it, it was around about 700, so like sort of like 2,000, 3,000 blocks of stone, or slabs of stone to do this. And I also made it 3 wide. And as you can see, it's a very long way. But it was interesting. As I also discovered another witch's island. Oh, weird when it isn't painting quickly, huh? But it's fine. But you can't even see where it's going to. Yes, sorry, it's a very long way, and it took a very long time to do this. And I think you can't see anything yet. Even if you could, it probably isn't drawn in. And the position was something like minus 1,000, I think. I'd use the air signal, but I haven't got any enough LP in the network, so I'd just end up taking LP from me. But what I'll do is before coming back here, I think I'll just cut it off and don't. I think we're nearly there now. Here we go. So the idea was to reach this island here. It's a tiny little island, but does have two hives. So it's got one meadows hive, and it'll have one forestry hive. And the biome, so look at the map, it should tell me it's plains. What I will do now, as while I'm here, is to put a marker. So let's put a marker where we currently are, so just right click it, and we shall say hives. In fact, it really is, should probably call it, wouldn't it be grand, because that's the actual task of this quest. And we shall, won't make it player deaths, we'll make it quests. And that's the marker, and then we shall change its colour. What colour should we make it? Not green. Yellow sounds like a good colour for hives. Ah, now you can see the other Witch's Island. And of course that is a good source of dirt. And the reason I didn't want to use it before is actually no reason. So, I shall cut this now and come back as soon as I've got back to base. So, see you in a second. Right, I'm just coming back now. That long walk. I also did this as well. I extended the Aubrey farm. This is why I want to get as quickly as possible anyway the harvester. But the first thing I think I need to do, as a matter of priority, is to extend the mob spawner, because I'm not getting enough blood now. So what we'll carry on doing, so I've got plenty of health, get some more food, and make some more runes of sacrifice. Before I make the tier 4 altar, I will actually, what I'm going to do with the tier 3 over here is I'm going to move it before I make the tier 4 altar, because with the tier 4 we can do the Well of Suffering, and the Well of Suffering then gives us a large amount of blood, because the mobs will spawn and they get killed just by automatically, as it were. So the first thing I wanted to do was to make some more runes. So here I've got the setup for that, but I need more stone. Let's have a look. I wanted 9, didn't I? And I think yes. It goes like that. And what we need, I don't need this one with me because this is a standard blood rune. I need some stone. And what I can do in the altar here is I can just about make a reinforced slate. Now the recipe for reinforced slate is, let's have a look at that one before I making it a fool of myself again. So better type slate, just not that. Here we go. And you can here see the different types of slate. The blank slate, the reinforced slate, that's the imbued slate, and the demonic slate. So this is tier 4, tier 3, tier 2. And what we need is 2000 LP, so, and we need 1000 LP. So for each reinforced slate we need 3000 LP. Which is, quick calculation, 15 cuts of the knife, which I can do. Sacrificial knife, because I've got 18 hearts, so check that pretty quick. Actually, that was 16, I think. Oh, no, 15, perfect. So then I can simply put two slates in here, two stone in here. How much blood do I know? I need more than that, don't I? That would actually make just one. So here's now time to use a golden apple. Eat a golden apple, because that will make this faster. Oops, what have I just done? Now I can start cutting myself. Hopefully I have enough in the altar. Not, oh, this is starting to die down again, isn't it? Hopefully I'm going to do it. If not, I'm going to have another trouble. Another half heart, quick. I don't think I'm going to be able to do it, am I? This happens, if I've got it wrong, it happens a lot. Tell you what we'll do, we shall quickly go and get a notch apple. Eat that, and then we can do this a lot faster. Oops, am I hitting? But let's get this filled up as much as possible. See, there's plenty of regen on a notch apple. You can really do that. A lot of blood in that altar. And there we have two slates. And the altar's full. So let's take those out. That's a bit of a stress. I should make sure the altar's a bit fuller before I start, shouldn't I? So these two reinforced slates now make the rune of sacrifice. And I'm going to carry on doing that until I've got all of those. But there is another thing I'd like to make. And that is another sigil. If I can, that is. What I would like to do is to make the sigil of magnetism. For that I need a magician's blood orb, an imbued slate, blocks of iron, 3 gold. Now this is the hard one here. I need a block of gold and 25,000 LP. Now the reason I need, this is one of the reasons I'm getting all of these runes of sacrifice made. Because with the runes of sacrifice, let me put this stuff away over here somewhere. It's a bit full at the moment. And I don't think I showed you this either. What I've been doing here was a bit more automation. I put a hopper on top of the pulverizer and a chest, a gold chest in the middle, and the items from the pulverizer are ending up in here, and you can see I've got quite a lot of metals in pulverized form, plenty of sand and the gravel, that's a byproduct as well. The sawmill here, and beside the sawmill I've got a cyclic assembler, and that's what the blood's for here. It's coming in here, going to the cyclic assembler, and on this side I want to put the water, so I've got water coming in from a tank, and I would like to move this igneous extruder and aqueous accumulator over to this side. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to use a gravity gun. So let's have a look what I need for a gravity gun. And here it is, the gravity gun. So it's 4 ender pearls, no problem, 1 diamond, 2 iron ingots, and some 1 block of obsidian. Not really a big problem, except for maybe I haven't got enough for the ender pearls at the moment, because for some reason I'm not getting very many endermen. You can see the blood's going down all the time. This is because it's being used now as filling up this apprentice blood orb, so I'm getting a 5,000 LP in the network. I'm backing up, it's not very what I wanted to open. And you'll see plenty of items in here, some of which I don't really want. Slime plant seed, yes. Put those away. And what I do is I come along once I've got one. I just dig up the one I've got here, like this. It'll fall. Oh, I didn't fall down that time. And put in another one. So now I've run out of food. I can do that again. And maybe I've been doing this long enough now to see if I've got any more. Lady of Soros, not ready yet. Don't know how long the cooldown period for this one is. 3 days. And I haven't killed enough anyway. But there's some more down here. Let's do and kill those. So you see the altar's also gone right down to almost empty. Eat. Yes. Actually, let's have a look how much blood I've got in the oven. It should now. I've got 5,000 LP in, which is the capacity of this. Therefore, it's not smoking anymore. It's not enough. But the apprentice blood orb is in here, I think, which I'm using at the moment to make the runes. So let's have a look. I've got some plant seeds here. I didn't want slime plant seeds and some repulsion plant seeds. I've got some dirt and I've got a lava crystal, which I can put back now, because what was happening is that I had left on the signal of green grove and I was using LP. What's also I've got here is another slime trophy. I've got two slime trophies now. That's interesting. This is because I've been killing slimes. That's when they spawned. So let's put the slime trophy up here. Using this sword, the looting three, and quite often with the looting three sword, you'll get some trophies. Right, where am I up to? Some more food, of course. Even at this stage, I'm eating quite a lot of food. So how much have we got in here? 10,000. So we can do another two stones. That would be quite safe in this case. So let's put on the hopper. If I split one like that, press two in there. In fact, I actually could do three. And I could probably go and do some over this side as well. Let's have a look what we got in this. Signal out of the way, let's have a look what it tells me. 4,000. See, that goes down very slowly now, and which is actually the blood's going into the pipes. It goes at about 20 ticks. So I do actually have enough at the moment to do two stone. So let's just put that like that. Take that out of there, put that back into here. Actually, I'll take the arrows and the rusting flesh out again, put those up there, take the food, and slay a few more mobs, even bats. So the altar is now standing at nearly 10,000 again, and in fact that's the first level. I have to be careful with these, because this is a tier 3 altar, and if I leave them too long, they'll become imbued slates, which I don't want. Unlike the tier 2 altar, which I can simply leave and forget, this one I've got to be careful with. That's another mob. That's always good to have, because it'll help me with the... I dropped some leather pants, that one. And a few bit of XP too. Hey, it's gone. There we are. Now, what have we got now? Reinforced slates, fantastic. So, let's make another two of these. And I shall come back, actually, I won't do all of these now for you, when the altar is complete. So I'll see you in a short while. Bye for now.